figures, then we're gonna have to pull off one hell of a data heist today.
Oh, I'm ready as I'll ever be, Marshall. I'm just sick and tired of my little Toby refusing to eat his nightly radishes. The little boy I raised would never behave this way. It's gotta be the influence of aliens.
Aliens? You think we might see a picture of them?
I don't know what we're gonna find, but I know that whatever it is, it's going to change the world as we know it.
Ooh, look at this big old file cabinet here. And it's color-coded. Somebody's a good organizer.
No, hold on, don't touch that. We have to check for bugs.
Let's see. Carol's touching it.
Great.
Looks like the folders are arranged alphabetically. I bet the aliens picked corn. I mean, alien pictures are in the A line. A for aliens.
Wait a minute,
everyone.
What about this one?
What was that?
I don't know, but it was beautiful. Let's take a little peek inside, shall we? Wait a minute. Marshall, this is in your handwriting.
Oh, you know what? We shouldn't read that.
I've got 8 more P's today. Never sits well in my tummy. Hope to sleep better tonight despite the rain.
Wait a minute, is this your diary? Look, you guys hired me to find government secrets. Not hurtful ones.
While we're telling secrets, I guess I'll just come right out and say it. I've loved fucking aliens. Especially a nice, juicy, green one.
We know. That's weird.
The only reason we brought you along is because you can hack a computer better than anyone on this side of the Mississippi. Now, does anyone want to enjoy some apple slices and granola while we read the rest of Marshall's secrets?
That's adorable, and I would love that, but we don't have time. We need to figure out who faked the moon landing. Who are the lizard people in the White House? Is North Dakota a real place?
It's going to take us a really long time because there are 4 different alphabets here. English, Spanish, American, and ancient Icelandic runes.
I guess I'll start with the ancient Icelandic runes. That's what I know best. Let's see. The government file on Frankenstein.
Oh, prank sometimes.
I'm the best one. It's a bonfire. Turn the lights out. I'm burning everything you motherfuckers talk about. It's a bonfire. Turn the lights out. I'm burning everything you motherfuckers talk about. You got these rappers talk shit, start killing. Fuck that cat, fools, like an arch villain. Oh, fuck this out, they got all that.
Father, seed donor. How are babies made?
Well, squirts and a blanc love each other very much. The squirts begins by extending its proboscis to its full length. Then the blorp releases its inner fluids, which start to boil into a green and viscous fog. Now it's spicy, okay? It's sticky and surrounded, and it starts to spin. Picture the strongest fan in the world.
Oh, my,
I've got it all set up. Now, if anybody or anything tries to hurt the president, they'll taste the sweet justice of my hot lead.
Man, I'm so glad you started this secret service. It's like we're bodyguards, but we're actually secret. No one knows about us. Not even the president. This is such a cool club.
We're like guardian angels.
God, you're my best friend, Lee Harvey Oswald.
And you're my best friend, Elvis Presley.
Boy, howdy. Do you remember that one time we stopped the president from eating the ice cream by shooting the ice cream?
He was lactose intolerant. That could have been bad.
Sure was bummed about the ice cream, though.
Oh no, Elvis!
Oh, what's wrong, Lee?
I can see through my scope. The president, there's a bee on his neck.
Oh no, Lee Harvey Oswald, the president's allergic to bees. One sting from a bee can kill him instantly.
And this bee looks hopping mad.
What are you gonna do?
I'm gonna do the only thing I know how to do. I'm gonna shoot that bee off the President of the United States.
Are you sure you can make it?
Elvis, I'm the most skilled marksman of the 1960s. I shot the cap off of the President's Coca-Cola bottle at 1,500 yards when he couldn't find a bottle opener. I got this.
That's true. You're the best.
All right, now I just need to be careful. Careful.
Tickle fight!
Elvis!
What?
You idiot!
What'd I do?
You disturbed my process!
Oh, boy.
How many times have I told you? Never disturb the process!
No. Well, did you miss?
Miss! I shot his dang head off is what I did!
No. What happened with the bee?
And the bee stung him!
No! Allergic to those! Oh, do you think he's gonna make it?
It's hard to tell. Elvis, we're probably gonna have to get out of here. We're probably not gonna see much of each other anymore.
Just don't even say that to me right now, man.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, Lee Harvey Oswald. Well, there goes the only man I'll ever love.
Wait, hold on. He said something about giving him. What was that? I think he was. Oh, you've taken the bait. Now it's something that you hate. The more we check, the less we talk. How about something in your sock?
You mean like our foot? You want me to give you my foot?
No, don't give him your whole foot for just a little bit of stew.
If the word is cruel, let's duel, you fool. Cause thumbs are crumbs to me, you dumb bum. Hey, hey, how's that sound, boo?
I think he wants our thumbs now. You know, a thumb, a foot, that's nothing for some hot stew. I say we do it.
Yeah, I'm cool. Get the hatchet.
Wee woo, wee woo, oh, wee woo, wee woo, wee woo, wee woo, wee woo, wee woo. Police!
What's going on here?
There was a man with a mask and he spoke in rhymes and.
Did he try to give you stew?
Yes!
Oh god, it's happening again. Tricky Pete, the worst criminal this town has ever seen. I'd give anything just to catch him.
Like a bird, dead, like a heartbeat.
fellow officer. I have some theories about what might have happened. Well, that's okay. I think I got this one about wrapped up. The gunshot wound, the bloody fingerprints, I'll have this guy by sundown. Oh, so you wouldn't want an eyewitness? Yes, I would. What do you have? Oh, I didn't see nothing. I'm just making small talk. But I have some theories.
And what might those theories?
Well, for starters, it could have been like a Cthulhu type situation. So Cthulhu, he's a mayor. He could have shot down a big old beam of laser right through this poor man's chest, just one place on time.
I really don't think
okay,
that's
you're right. You're so right. What about maybe, you know, it could have been like a Scooby-Doo type of goo with no one on the inside, and you're like, well, but how is he operating? Because no one's in there.
Again, I really don't think that's right.
You're so right. That's why I'm thinking maybe it was like an aquaterrestrial sort of being. It's like
aquaterrestrial? Wouldn't that just be like,
you know what? Say no more words. Just the riot. But this is why I'm thinking potentially it could have been Sully.
Which Sully?
For Monsters Inc. of course.
That Sully isn't real.
What about Sully the pilot?
That doesn't make sense.
Well, have you thought perhaps of the theory that this man is in fact a goose?
The body is right there. Definitely not a goose.
Well, in death, this man is a human. But in life, he could have been a goose. At which point, Sully saw him and did all he knows how to do.
That doesn't make sense.
Well, it doesn't make no sense. But you're right.
You're so right.
Which is why perhaps it was God. Just thinking, you know what? Here we go. Fear me.
This wound was definitely made by a gunshot.
Well, a gun that gained sentience. A perfect murder.
I think someone shot the gun.
Correct. A perfectly trained marionette. He was on it. He knew what to do. Just operating it from wherever he was. But not here. No prints. No suspect.
You know what? I'm going to take all of these theories and I'll run them by my boss, okay?
Okay.
I'll let you know if anything comes up.
Make sure you do, though. I'm curious now. Invested. Thanks for letting me help out. Just sort of anything will break up the monotony of drowning my creamed corn. Bye.
Oh my god, the gun! It has gained sentience!
No! Sorry! Just me! I'm leaving out my old rifle! Just in case Sully comes in the night thinking I'm a goose!
Secret service agents. We gotta make sacrifices if we want to save the president. You know what? John Wilkes Booth? Sometimes you're a real pain in the ass. Oh, come on, Carl Marx. Don't be... You're right. I can't stay mad at you, Johnny Boy.
There's that cute little smile.
Tickle bite. Stop. Okay. We're on guard.
Hey, are you thirsty?
You know what? John Wilkes Booth? I'm pretty thirsty.
Say, Karl Marx, do you want me to get you something to drink?
You know what? I would love that, John Wilkes Booth.
Hey, here's an idea. Why don't we get the president in on this drink order?
The president? You mean Abraham Lincoln?
That's his name.
Let's do it.
All right, I'll just go head on right over there.
Oh, wait! Your shoe's on top.
Oh, don't worry about that, Karl Marx. I'm a famous actor. I gotta be nimble on my feet, you know?
Okay. Wait, John Wilkes Booth, why do you have a fully loaded and also cocked gun in your hand?
Because I'm a sworn protector of the president. What if I see a threat?
Fair enough.
All right.
Hey, are you drunk?
Not really.
Okay. Hurry up, I'm thirsty as a hound. John Wilkes Booth?
I should have listened to you, Karl Marx.
Why?
Well, you're not going to believe this.
Lay it on me, John Wilkes Booth.
Well, I was running, and I tripped on my shoelace, and I blew the president's head clean off the clock.
Our president?
One and the same, I'm afraid.
Is he okay?
At this point, it's anybody's guess.
What should we do?
Well, Karl Marx, I'm going to do the only thing I know how to do. I'm going to jump down onto that stage and try to cheer everybody up with some bad news.
We're probably not going to see much of each other after this. Karl Marx, John Wilkes Booth, you're going to change the world someday, kid.
I'll do it! I'll do it for you, John Wilkes Booth!
Landlord, Lawrence
members of the Alien Council, Lord C and I traveled to ER to see just how feasible a total world takeover would be.
We spent 4 space years observing Earth and its inhabitants. We are proud to report back to the mothership that ER is the perfect candidate for alien domination.
Ooh!
The climate is temperate, the food plentiful, and the dominating species, humans, are incredibly docile. In fact, we were able to capture one and bring this human back to the ship.
Your Highness, Alien Council, we present to you a human being.
Well, I think something's wrong.
Oh my god, are you pregnant? infection.
Oh my god, if Steve gave you some gross STD, I'll kick his ass, Tracy. Wait a minute, it was Steve? You slept with Steve? Steve only eats radioactive waste.
Oh my literal god!
swan.
But there's something that I need to tell you.
Don't even. I already know.
Really?
Yeah. You're a vampire.
Wait, what?
Yeah, you're a vampire.
No, I'm not.
You don't have to hide it anymore, Edward. I love you just the same.
No, Bella, I'm not a vampire.
See the way your pale skin glows in the sun.
Yeah, that's a skin condition.
So I've seen you drink human blood.
Yeah, that was a joke at Jesse's Halloween party. You know, it was fruit punch.
You're always so cold.
Yeah, it's a skin condition.
Well, that's not what you were going to tell me. What were you going to tell me?
I was going to tell you that my family's moving to Kansas. So yeah.
Will you write to me?
No! No! Who thought I was an immortal vampire? So, I'm gonna go.
Out fork, which clearly told me to get antibiotics.
Ooh, it's moving again!
great mother spirit must really want you to ask me on a date.
I don't think it says that.
Ah, he speaks again! He says, Catherine and Wilkin are meant to be forever together, and they are so in love! Oh my God, I'm serious! That's so crazy. That's like saying that I love Catherine and Catherine loves Wilkin, but that's totally not true. I mean, unless Catherine loves Wilkin.
Okay, I think I see what's going on here.
You?
Yeah, I do. Wilkin, you're a really nice, quirky little guy. Okay, I'm free on Tuesday at 4. How about we get coffee?
Really?
No, you're a freak.
Please! I'll do anything you're going to give me, you!
What?
Monster.
how do humans have sex?
I don't know, but I'm pretty focused on Monsters, Inc. hiring. Do you think that they could give me a job?
I thought you had a weird thing for aliens, not for monsters.
I'll take what I can get.
We've looked through all of these files, and we haven't found anything to help my poor little Toby. Say, I have an idea. Let's read the last entry in Marshall's diary to lift our spirits.
No, seriously, don't read that one. Don't read it. Don't read it. Don't read that one.
If March 13th, 2017, dear diary, I can't keep pretending to be human. I will take them to the government center, and then I will abduct them because I am an alien. Marshall, is this true?
Well, yes.
Oh my God, I can't believe it. We trusted you. I'm leaving.
Ain't that just the way it goes?
So, are we doing this?
Yeah, I guess. Let me just get my proboscis ready.
Jack.
Regina.
Isabella.
Here.
Milena.
Andrew.
Xavier.
Cameron.
Woo!